If I step into this area, will anything happen to me? Yep, I no longer need to pay for gas. In this video, you will learn how to teleport from one point to another in Unreal Engine. I will first show how to do it using Cast 2, then with a much more efficient method, Blueprint Interface. I will help you understand the logic as clearly as possible. If anything is unclear, say so in the comments. Let's begin. I'm in the third person template. The template doesn't matter. You could even teleport a car if you want. Right click in the content browser, Blueprint class, Actor Blueprint. Let's open the blueprint. For the teleport point, I'll make a simple platform using a sphere. I'm scaling it way down on the Z-axis. Good enough. It just needs to be clear it's a teleport point for now. I add a box collision that will trigger when the character enters it. With box collision selected, in the details panel, I click the plus icon next to on component begin overlap, which adds the event to the event graph to fire when we enter the box collision. I call the Cast2 BP third person character node and connect its object pen to the other actor pen. This way, when our character enters the collision, the nodes we add next will run. Let's create a variable and set its type to transform. I drag it into the event graph as a get. I right-click the pin and choose split struct pin. Now we can operate on the location, rotation, and scale transform values separately. From the Cast2 output pin, I call set actor location and rotation. We need to access the character's location so it can teleport from that location to the teleport point we set. For that, I call get actor transform, and from its return value pin, I call transform location. I connect the location pin of the variable we created to the location pin on transform location, and I connect the return value pin to new location on the set actor location and rotation node. I also connect the rotation pin of our variable to new rotation. Set teleport to true. Compile, and to edit our variable in the level, tick instance editable. Now we can set the teleport destination in the level. Compile again and go to the level tab. Press Ctrl and space to open the content browser, then drag the blueprint we created, our teleport point, into the scene. Yeah, this looks fine. As you see, the transform values appeared in the details panel, so we can set where we will teleport. But there's no indicator showing where we'll teleport to. For that, go back to our blueprint and tick Show 3D widget in the variables details. Yep, now we can see where we'll teleport. I won't bother with the details panel. We can just drag it to where we want in the scene. Let's go to this corner. I think a top view will be much better. Yeah, we almost went out of bounds. This spot looks fine. Alright, let's start the game and see if we can teleport. What? Dude, what's going on? Ah, I get it. We didn't connect our character to the target pen. Since self is selected, the blueprint is teleporting itself somewhere. Let's connect the other actor pen to the target pen. Compile and run. Wow, that was abrupt. Yes, we can teleport. Congrats, you are now the biggest enemy of car companies. But right now, we're dumping too much carbon into the environment. The Cast2 node uses a lot of processing power. So let's use a much, much more efficient method instead, Blueprint Interface. In the content browser, right-click, Blueprint, Blueprint Interface. Name it and open it. And a new world opens up. For now, we don't need the graph or details areas. In the My Blueprint panel, I create a function, compile, and exit. I open the teleport point blueprint, click class settings at the top, and in the details panel, under implemented interface, I select the blueprint interface we created. As you can see, it appeared in the interfaces section of the My Blueprint tab on the left. I do the same in our character's blueprint. Now both blueprints have the same interface. I'll build it first, then explain the logic. Let's get rid of the Cast2 node. From other actor, I call doesObjectImplementInterface. From its return value, I create a branch and connect its true pin to the next node. I right-click the other actor pin and choose Promote to Variable to convert other actor into an actor variable and connect that to the branch. On doesObjectImplementInterface, I select the blueprint interface we created. So essentially, we said, does the person entering this area have the BPI interface implemented? If true, then teleport. Compile and start. Yes, I forgot again. Guess I should take B12. Let's connect the other actor variable to the target pin. Compile and start. And yes, now both nature lovers and our computer are happier. Can we add as many teleports as we want? Let's try and see. Yes, as you can see, my dear friend, you could even make a game where nobody ever walks and turn our character into an obese, lifeless person. But it's teleporting too suddenly. There's no punch at all. I've got an idea. If we exaggerate the camera effect we used in the previous video, maybe we can create an interstellar wormhole effect. Let's try it. Let's set up the effect like we did in the previous video. Afterwards, we'll also use an interface here. Let's recall what we did. I create two custom events, one to start the effect and one to end it. I create a Boolean variable and drag it in. I call notBoolean, then from its output, I create a branch and connect it to the custom event. I set our variable on the true pin of the branch and mark it true. I create a float variable. I drag in our camera, call getFieldOfView, and set our float variable from its output and connect it with the Boolean variable. I drag the Boolean variable and create another branch, connecting it to the ending custom event. I create a timeline and open it. Track, add float track. With shift plus left click, I place two points. First point, 0, 0, second point, 0.1, 0.1. I set the timeline length to 0.1. I select the points, right click, auto for a smoother transition. Back to the event graph. I connect the effect start nodes to play and the end nodes to reverse. From the update pin, I call set field of view. From in field of view, I call lerp and connect the alpha pins. I connect the float variable to A, then from that variable, I call add and connect it to B. I typed 1000 as the value. Let's see what happens. From the direction pin, I call equal enum and select backward. From finished, I create a branch and connect its condition to equal enum. I set the Boolean variable on the true pin of the branch and leave it false. Okay, we prepared our camera effect. Now let's call it as a function that will run when the character enters our teleport blueprint. How will we call it? We won't. That's why we'll use a blueprint interface. Alright, let's learn how. I open the blueprint interface we created, and instead of custom events, I create two functions and compile. As you can see, the functions we created appeared in the blueprints that have our interface. I right-click and choose Implement Event. And we now have two events. I delete the custom events and connect these events. Do you get the logic? I think you do. Blueprint interfaces can be executed like custom events and used in each blueprint that has those interfaces. You'll understand even better in a moment. I open our teleport blueprint. The effect will start before teleport and return to normal, so we'll call the start FOV before set actor location and rotation and end FOV after it as a message. From our other actor variable, I call the start effect as a message. I do the same for the end effect and connect them in this order. I add a delay so the effect is noticeable, otherwise it happens instantly and we can't perceive it. compile and let's see. Well, go back already. What happened now, man? What is this? This is an equal enum. Sorry, folks, human error. Let's delete this, add equal enum, and select backward. Compile and check. And there we go. But this effect would be better if it didn't last this long. What if I set the delay to 0.1? Let's see. Yes, we just killed our traffic excuse. After all, every new technology has bugs. Hopefully, we won't teleport to the wrong place.
Have you subscribed?